Well, the Rock and Roll Half Marathon is coming up in just a couple of months, and while many are training to meet personal goals, others are running for a cause. The Ronald McDonald House Providence being one of them. We get a chance to meet with one family who stayed in the house and continues to give back.
Hitting the pavement, braving the weather, training for months. Running the Rock and Roll Half Marathon may be on your bucket list, but there's a way to help charities as well.
Ronald McDonald House is really a home away from home for families that have children who are suffering from diseases, whether they're life-threatening or they're going in for procedures. It offers comfort, support, warmth, good food, and also proximity to your kids. And that is so important when your child is sick.
The sweat and tears on race day are nothing compared to those shed right here. The Ronald McDonald House Providence provides a home away from home for families who are coping with devastating times.
11 years ago, I had a son that was born at Women and Infants Hospital. And a healthy pregnancy, everything was fine, but an hour and a half after he was born, he started having seizures. And we didn't know, but it was going to be a long haul.
Mary Kay not only spent time at the house for her son Lucas, but again for her second son.
When my second son Connor was born, he needed the NICU services at Women and Infant as well. And we knew the prognosis was a lot better for him.
Just a baby at the time, Connor does not remember when his family stayed at the Ronald McDonald House, but he knows just how important it was.
I love the Ronald McDonald House because when I was born, I was sick and I felt warmth because my mom was there.
The comfort, the support, and the love of the house made Mary Kay's experience a warm one.
It was a place to lay our head down. It was a place to go when the doctors were doing their rounds and we weren't allowed to stay with our son. And it was just a place where it was a supportive atmosphere for people who really cared about us and our child were. And where we could go, we could cry, we could talk, or we could just go and be alone in a quiet place if we needed it.
Though she lost Lucas, his memory remains through photographs and an engraving on the house wall.
If you wanted to talk to somebody who knew kind of what you were going through, there was somebody here. Or if you wanted absolute silence or just a hug, the people were there and available for us.
Ronald McDonald House Providence helps so many families in need. It's through walks and races like the Rock and Roll Half Marathon that people can in turn aid the house.
They're doing it for not only the families, but most of all the kids. They're really going to make a big difference in their lives, because I think kids' recovery is so much better when their parents are there and surrounding them with that love.
Personal accomplishments will be met on race day, but knowing that you sacrificed your body for a good cause makes crossing the finish line all the more special.
I wish them that they will beat their children or anyone, that they will be healed good, and that they will be watched over by God.
And joining me now from the Ronald McDonald House Providence is Nicole Anderson with more on how to get involved. Good morning.
Good morning.
So we just saw a lovely story about, you know, Mary Kay and her boys and her experience at the Ronald McDonald House. What exactly does the Ronald McDonald House do?
Well, we're there to provide support for families. They can come stay with us when their children are being treated for medical reasons, unexpected, right after birth. Mm-hmm. Whatever. We're there. We're right across the street. They can come have a nice meal, have a bed to sleep in, warm shower. We're there just to support the family so they can get through a tough time.
And you know from personal experience just how important that can be to be so close, because you actually started off staying at the house.
That's right. After my second daughter was born 10 years ago, she had to stay back in the hospital after I was released, and I was sleeping in waiting room chairs, wherever I could find a spot, because I didn't have a bed to sleep in. Mm-hmm. And then one of the social workers came up to me and asked if I had my name in at the Ronald McDonald House. And at that time, I had no idea that the Ronald McDonald House was right across the street. So I put my name in, and there was a waiting list at the time, but when something opened up, we were able to stay over at the Ronald McDonald House, and my younger daughter and husband were able to come down and stay with me mm-hmm. at that time, which meant a lot, especially for now my oldest daughter. She had no idea why her baby sister couldn't come home and she couldn't be near her, so having them that close to her was not only good for my daughter Cody, who was in the hospital, but also for my oldest daughter, who, you know, didn't really understand what was going on.
Yeah, and then from there, after your experience at the house, you started volunteering?
That's right, I started volunteering. I did a few overnight manager positions and volunteered actually at the family room at Hasbro Hospital. And then I had received a pamphlet in the mail for a running club for the Ronald McDonald House. So I joined the running club for the Ronald McDonald House. So I've kind of been involved for about 10 years now.
Yeah, you have a lot of different ties. How can people at home get involved?
They can, any way possible. They can come in, they can volunteer in the house, they can volunteer in the family room. We have groups come in and they provide meals every night. Our families have a hot meal every night provided by different groups of people. We have corporations come in. It's a great team building activity to come in and make dinner for families, and it's any way possible, really.
It's so nice to see all the people come together and, you know, support the same cause. And speaking of which, the runners who will be running a half marathon for Ronald McDonald House, how exactly will that benefit the house? I mean, what is it like? All the money that's raised will go directly to?
What we ask is that if you sign up to run with the Ronald McDonald House, we will cover your registration fee. We ask that you raise a minimum of $200, make a good faith effort to raise a minimum of $200, which is really a lot easier than it sounds. We have a website that you can just start your own fundraising page, and you know, people, you put it out in an email and you'll make that in no time. And all the money that we have left over after paying the registration fees goes directly to the house, whether it is bedding, supplies, food, whatever we need, whatever you need at your house, whatever you need to supply at your house, we need to supply at our house.
Exactly.
So any of the leftover money will go directly to support the families there. Yeah.
Excellent. Well, it's a great cause, so make sure you get involved, raise that $200. Send that to your friends, your co-workers, everyone, a couple bucks each way.
Nicole,
thank you so much for coming in. And again, there is still time to sign up for the Providence Rock and Roll Half Marathon. It's coming up in August. So for information on the race, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.